guys, welcome back to another episode of Dimitra's Dishes. On this channel, I teach you how to make easy and delicious recipes that are perfect for sharing with the people that you love the most, so that way you can create beautiful memories too. Now, today I'm gonna teach you how to make the ultimate Greek-American gyro sandwich. Now, I have to emphasize on the Greek-American part because I did a gyro recipe a few years back, sort of at the beginning of the channel, and I got a lot of hate comments down below commenting and pointing out how that's not a traditional Greek gyro, and it really isn't. They're actually right. I should have emphasized that it's a Greek-American gyro. It is the most popular sandwich, Greek sandwich in America, and it's very different from the traditional gyro that's served in Greece. In Greece, they layer lamb or pork or chicken, and then they cook it on a rotisserie, slice it up, and then they put it in a sandwich with pretty much the same things that we're gonna do today. Tomato, onion, some bell pepper, and tzatziki sauce, or sometimes other dips, but we're not going there today. But in America, the gyro meat is more like, it's kind of like an in-between of sausage slash meatloaf, so that's what we're making today. It's usually made with beef, lamb, or chicken. Again, today we're using beef because it's still quarantine time here in America, and it is very hard to find ground lamb, so you can do a combination of lamb and beef, all lamb or all beef, it's completely up to you, or you can use chicken. Now, the gyro meat that's served here in America is almost like a mystery meat. You really don't know what's in there. There's a lot of stuff in there. Most of the time, it's unhealthy. It is sort of tasty if you like that kind of stuff, but this right here is gonna be very fresh and delicious and still so, so tasty with a lot of flavor. And it all comes together in a food processor. If you don't have a food processor, you can use a stand mixer like a KitchenAid, or you can just knead it all together by hand. I just really like the texture that the food processor creates. So if you have one, take it out. We're gonna start by putting the garlic cloves in. I have a lot of garlic here. So I'm gonna put it in there and I'm gonna let them mince up. So the recipe that I'm gonna have online is gonna be for 2 pounds of meat. I'm using 3 pounds of meat today, so I am using a little bit more onion. I have two small onions here instead of one big onion for the 2 pounds. And I'm gonna put them in the food processor and pulse them until they're finely chopped. Okay, so the onion and garlic are ready. I'm gonna add the meat, so I have ground beef over here. This ground beef is 90% lean and 10% fat. I also have two sprigs of rosemary that I'm gonna add just the leaves. Some salt. Now my formula for the salt is 1 teaspoon per pound. If you don't like food, if you can't have that much salt, you can just put as much as you like in here. Then we're gonna do a heaping teaspoonful of ground cumin, and I'm gonna add just a little bit more since we have that extra pound of beef in there. 2 teaspoons of dried oregano, but I'm gonna go ahead and add one more. Some black pepper. And for a little kick of heat, crushed red pepper flakes. If you don't want them, just leave them out. And I'm just gonna go ahead and pulse this until everything is combined. And in between, you can go in with a spatula and kind of mix everything all up. Trust me, it doesn't look that appetizing now, but this is delicious. It makes for the most delicious sandwiches. Perfect, this is ready. So now, if you're making the 2 pounds of meat that's gonna be listed on the recipe, then all you need is a loaf pan. You're just gonna transfer all of this meat into the loaf pan and just press it in there so that way it's nice and compact. But I have that extra pound of beef in here, so I am gonna put it into an 8-inch, this is a square baking pan. It's almost 3 inches deep, but use whatever you have. You can make this in a round pan too. It doesn't matter. The thing is, it should fit very compact and snug into whatever you're putting it in. So once it's in the pan, you want to bake it in a preheated oven. My oven is preheated at 325 degrees Fahrenheit. This is going to bake for about an hour or until the internal temperature reaches 165 degrees Fahrenheit. I usually look for color once it's golden brown on top. It takes about an hour, sometimes an hour and 15 minutes. Then once it's done baking, you want to take it out and let it rest completely. Let it rest completely, cover it with plastic wrap, and refrigerate it so that way all of the juices can be reabsorbed. This is much better sliced once it's cold. If you absolutely must slice it that same day that you're making it, then let it rest for about an hour before you do so. So I'm gonna bake it, then I'm gonna slice it, then we're gonna go ahead and form our sandwiches. So when the gyro has chilled in the refrigerator, it's going to be so much easier to slice. This does taste best when the slices are as thin as they can get, because then it tastes just like the original, the one that you would get at a Greek restaurant here in America. So do chill it if you have the chance. Otherwise, you can definitely cut it into thicker slices too, because if it's at room temperature or warm and you try to cut thin slices, it's just gonna crumble on you, so you won't be able to get those very thin slices like the ones that I cut here. Then once you slice them, then go ahead and transfer the slices to a container, an airtight container that's gonna stay good in the refrigerator, and then pour all of the juices that are in the baking pan on top, so that way all of that flavor is still there. This will keep fresh in your refrigerator all week long, and it is perfect to serve alongside eggs. You can put it on top of salads and eat it like a nice salad for like a weekday lunch or a weeknight dinner if you're keeping things low carb. There's so much flavor in this, you will not miss the bread. But if you want to make that delicious pita sandwich, then go ahead and make homemade pita bread. I'll put the link right here up in the card section. And that pita, by the way, is the best pita that you'll ever taste in your whole entire life. It's soft and delicious, and you could turn this into a pocket sandwich or the way that they're served at the stores here in the restaurants in America. Now, also go ahead and slice some red onion or whatever onion you have, some tomatoes, some bell peppers. You're definitely going to need some creamy tzatziki, which is a Greek yogurt, and shredded cucumber and garlic sauce that just goes great with this. Now you're going to have to warm these a little bit. So I have a cast iron skillet heating over medium heat. I'm going to drizzle just a tiny bit of olive oil on it, and I'm going to cook them on each side until they're slightly crisp and golden, and then we're going to put the sandwich together. So once the meat is nice and golden, then go ahead and warm up a pita and then put a little bit of tzatziki, lettuce, tomato, and bell pepper on top. And then the crisp golden slices of gyro meat go on top of that. I like to add a little bit more tzatziki, and now it is time to take a bite. Just looks amazing. This is not the prettiest thing to do on camera, but I'll take one for the team. Oh my God. That whole combination. It is better than a gyro that you'll get at a local Greek restaurant. I mean, if you want to make something healthy and delicious and get all of that flavor at home, make sure you make the pita bread with it. The gyro is perfectly crisp after it's cooked on the cast iron skillet. It gets nice and crisp in some places, but it's still juicy in the center, and it is loaded with flavor. All of those herbs, you can really taste in there, the perfect amount of seasoning. And that tzatziki sauce is just creamy and the perfect, nice, refreshing touch to the whole sandwich. I think you guys are gonna absolutely love this. I think if you make this for your family, they're gonna definitely love you more. The best thing about it is that the meat can be made in like double or triple batches, and it'll stay fresh in your refrigerator. You can freeze any leftovers and then just take it out whenever you need it. The recipe, as always, is in the description box down below, right underneath this video. All the exact measurements and the instructions are on there, and a lot of tips and tricks as well. I hope you guys enjoy it. I hope you guys go on this video right here to make this pita bread, and I will see you right over there. Bye, everyone.